Hello, I'm Amanda, also known as Shutter Monkey. Welcome to my vlog, Crafting with Shutter Monkey. This video blog is about knitting, crochet and patchworking quilting, although in this episode you're not going to see any crochet because I haven't crocheted anything in the past 2 weeks. Other places that you can find me online are Ravelry, I'm Shutter Monkey Designs on there. That's where I sell my knitting and my crochet patterns. I'm also on Lovecrafts, Shutter Monkey Designs again. You can find my knitting and crochet patterns on there too. I have an Etsy shop, Shutter Monkey Designs. I sell some handmade items through Etsy. I'm also on Payhip, I'm Shutter Monkey Designs there too. That's where I sell my quilting patterns. I'm on Instagram. You can find me on there. I'm Wee Shutter Monkey on Instagram. That's my personal account on there. I've also got a Facebook page, Shutter Monkey Designs, on there as well. Today is Friday, the 6th of November. I'll get this video edited over the weekend and get it uploaded as soon as I can, so it may be Monday before you guys are seeing this. I've got lots and lots of knitting to show you today. As I said already, no crochet, but lots and lots of knitting, and you'll see a wee shawl behind me. I'll tell you more about that later on in the knitting section, okay? So I think we'll jump straight in to knitting, okay? So we'll start with socks. Always start with socks, don't I? Right. The next sock pattern that I'm going to be releasing is this one here, my Fankle sock pattern. This one is a nice little cable twist down, running down the leg and down the foot. And it's also got a nice little lace section in between the cables too. You have to increase your stitch count. It's a medium sized sock, and you start off with 64 stitches, but you have to increase your stitch count to take into account those cables. As they're twisting round, they pull your tension, they pull your knitting in a wee bit, so it makes it a wee bit tighter. So if you carry on in 64 stitches, it won't fit you. It's a top down sock pattern, so you're going to start up here at the cuff. You're going to knit your cuff. It's a 2x2 rib, twisted 2x2 rib. If you find a twisted rib's a little bit tight for you, you can actually just do a regular rib if you like. You then move on to the leg pattern. You can shorten that leg too if you like. It's a 2x2 heel flap as well, and then you're going to work your heel turn and move on to your gusset. Now see this heel flap, see if you find you've got high instep, you can increase the size of that, and you can make that a wee bit longer if you need it. Everybody's got different shaped feet, haven't they? And when you're working your gusset decreases, if you already know how to do your gusset decreases, you don't really have to follow my instructions. I know some knitters will find that they need a longer gusset. They need the longer heel flap, and they need the longer gusset here, so they'll actually only decrease every third row rather than every second row. This pattern will be going on to Ravelry and Lovecrafts on the 12th of November. Thursday the 12th of November, it will be there for you to download. And again, it's a free pattern, just like my other ones. Just like all these ones here. The old shale one, the Helter Skelter and the Steelac. You're getting sick of seeing these yet. But they're all on, these three are all on Ravelry already. Can you tell I like pink and grey? There's a colour theme going here. And then this one is the next one to come, okay? The Fankle sock is still with test knitters just now. There are a couple of knitters that have still to finish it off, but they're almost done. And this one's with test knitters too, so I'll talk more about that in my next episode. Right, what's up next sock-wise? What have I finished? I haven't really finished much knitting-wise, to be honest. I spent a lot of time over the past 2 weeks pattern writing. I got some time in the computer. My husband was working away. He was supposed to be away for 4 days. And I thought, oh yay, I can get the computer all to myself, lots of patterns written up. But he was only away for 2 days. He came home early. But I did actually get, when he needs the computer, he's got to work from home, he needs a computer. I do get to use his laptop, but I don't really like using a laptop. I like the computer. There's lots of space at the computer, and you've got a double monitor, so you can be looking at other things. You can be doing your pattern writing on one screen, and then if you need to look at something else, you've got two screens to work with. I'm just spoiled, actually, to be honest. But it's more difficult on the laptop, and I always find when I type on the laptop, I make lots of errors, like just spelling mistakes and things like that as well. It's much easier in the computer. Anyway, I've spent a lot of time the past 2 weeks. I've been pattern writing quite a bit, getting a lot of things written up, just ready to be published or tested by other people. So that's what's taken up a lot of my time the past fortnight. Oh, and video editing. I really don't like video editing. I can't believe how many hours we spent editing that last video, the binding one, the binding tutorial. It's only a 15 minute video, but the length of time it takes to edit a video and actually just get it down to the length of video, all the relevant details that you maybe need, it just takes so long. And then you have to do a voiceover at the end as well. And see, just listening to your own voice over and over and over and trying to slot it in so it matches in the video. Oh, it's hard going. Pattern writing and video editing, that's what's been taking up a lot of my time the past 2 weeks. But I did get my Halloween socks finished. Didn't get them finished in time for Halloween. It was the 1st of November before I got these finished. So that's them. They're blocked now. Not the second socks there. They're blocked now. I'm still just sorting my wee ends and I can wear them. But I don't know whether to wear them now or put them away for next year. But I'll probably wear them now. Not me. So that was those. That was one finished thing. And the only other finished sock I've got is this one. I put wee sneak peeks of this onto Instagram. I was really nervous about sharing this. I'm always nervous when you have to share a new design. You wonder what people think. This is going to crinkle a wee bit, but it's because I've wrapped my sock blocker in some white tissue paper. I was hoping you would see the pattern a bit better. So here it is. I hope you can see that okay. And it's crinkling. Sounds like a present. So this is my candy cane socks. And I'm looking for test knitters for this one. Sorry, I'm going to try and stop moving it. That side's probably a wee bit bulgy looking, but it's because that's when the tissue paper is underneath. So just ignore that. I put the tissue paper under so you could see the candy canes. Because you couldn't see them very well when it was just the sock blocker. So I hope you can see that okay. I can't see very well on the wee screen. But there we go. That's my candy cane socks. This is a medium size sock, but it's an 8 stitch pattern repeat, so you'll very easily be able to adapt this to a large or a small size sock. I'm looking for test knitters to knit this for me, but I'm hoping to find knitters who can very quickly knit a sock for me, maybe in the space of 2 weeks rather than a month. I usually ask for a month, but I would like to get this released as quick as possible. I did consider just releasing it and just publishing it and not bother getting it tested, but I thought that was a wee bit unfair. It's going to be another free pattern, but I maybe should get it tested. Not so much to make sure there's no errors in the pattern, because if it's just a wee error, it's easy enough to work around it. Most people can figure it out. But it's a learning experience for me, getting test knitters to test your stuff. It's not just getting my patterns tested, it's been a learning experience for me. Some of the knitters that are test knitting for me, they've all been great. They've all been wonderful. And when you come up against problems or come up against wee hiccups, it's a good learning experience. It really has been a good learning experience for me, trying to figure out what's gone wrong and how they can sort out why socks aren't fitting. Anyway, this is the next one I'm looking for test knitters for. So I'm quite pleased with that design. And the shawl behind me, I know you're probably thinking, oh, she's always got a shawl pattern to match her socks. Well, I have actually got a shawl pattern to match this. So I hope you can see that okay there. This is a lovely yarn. It's by Fiberspace. It was a 150g skein, and I'll show you in a wee second how much yarn I had left over from this. But this is it's supposed to be snow falling. This is the snow falling here, and this is the wee roofs. It was supposed to be like a Christmas market. That's what I had in mind, and this was my little roofs. And the snow's falling onto my Christmas roofs, and you can see up here there's candy canes on here too. But I'm going to turn it around, see if she'll turn. And this is the front. The front has actually got really long. It's almost like, I'll take it off. It's this kind of shape here. Can you see that okay? It's three triangles. But these ones at the sides have been elongated with the candy canes on. And then there's this bit here, the square back, and again this side here is elongated, an elongated triangle with candy canes. I knitted this shawl, I think I knitted it in 2015, and I've still not published the pattern. I've got loads of patterns like that I've knitted up and then just thought, I'll get around to it. So I might release that. You can let me know what you think, if it's something that you would be interested in knitting. But it's got a lovely lace edging on it too. And this yarn's got a little bit of gold stellina through it. I hope you can see that. But it's just beautiful. It really is. And it fits really nicely around the body too. I'll just pop it back on here. Right. Oh, I was going to show you something, wasn't I? This is where you start this shawl. Here, in the middle. Okay. And that's my cast on edge. So I've just got my wee bit where I cast on, okay? And when I finish the edging, just find the end with the edging. And this is when I finish my edging. That's all I had left. That tiny wee bit. I've not sewn my two ends in yet, but that was it. From 150 grams, that's what was left. So I was playing yarn chicken the whole way around, finishing off that beautiful edging. Wondering if I was going to make it to the end, and I just made it. It's always nice when you play yarn chicken and win, isn't it? There we go. And she wraps quite nicely around your body. Keep your chest nice and warm when you're out in cold winter days. Wrap quite nicely underneath your coat. So I'll leave her sitting there just now, but that is, I do have a matching shawl pattern to go with. Slightly different shades of red, but they look nice together. If you have two of your socks and your shawl matching. I don't think most people worry about that when they go somewhere, do they? Anyway, this is the second sock. I've still got my Halloween stitch cosy on here. I started these socks before Halloween, so they're staying in the Halloween cosy until they're finished. So there we go. This is the second one. And I've just got by the heel flap, and I'm working. I think I've just finished the gusset decreases. Yeah. Yep. I'm just onto the foot now, so that'll not take me long to get that finished, another couple of nights. But it's been fun working in something different. I feel like these other patterns, I've been working on them for so long, because I started knitting probably in March this year. I knitted one of each sock, and then I had to write up the patterns before I knitted the second sock. So it feels like such a long time. These other ones have been on my mind, so I think that's the words I'm looking for. So test knitters for this one, and you can let me know if you want me to release that shawl pattern as well. But I've got plenty of yarn left over. That's what's left from my 100 gram skein. Plenty there. I think I've only used about half of it. So we'll pop these out of the way. And the other thing that I wanted to show you today was some Christmas yarn. It's from West Yorkshire Spinners. They're a UK based company, but they release a Christmas colourway every year. And I'm just going to show you some of their socks, because if you're looking to knit some Christmas socks and you don't know where to start and what yarn to buy, this stuff's great. This was the first one they released. I think this was 4 years ago. This is the Holly Berry colourway. Yep. I think that was their first one, Holly Berry. And I've put the contrasting cuffs. Got two there. I've got the contrasting cuffs, toes and heels on mine, but you don't have to do that if you don't want. And then 3 years ago, I think it was 3 years ago, don't quote me in that, I might have these mixed up. It was the candy cane socks. It was a candy cane colourway. And again, you don't have to put the contrasting heels, toes and cuffs in. I knitted three pairs of these. My husband's got a pair and my daughter's got a pair as well. But we've all got different variations of the heel, toes and cuffs. So if they all end up in the washing at the one time, I know whose is whose. But they were fun to knit. And we all sat and watched Elf last year. Well, I sat and watched Elf last year. And they came in and sat with me for a couple of minutes, just so I could get a picture of our feet all together. All our little candy cane socks in front of Elf. The next colourway, that one was discontinued for a while. I think they're only limited edition for Christmas, but they have re-released all these colourways, because that one was quite hard to get. I found it really difficult to get this one. This one was the next one. This was Fairy Lights. And again, I've put contrasting heel, toes and cuffs in, but you don't have to do that. I knitted a pair of these, another pair for my daughter, but hers are all turquoise, the heels, toes and cuffs. And again, so we know whose is whose. She's not a fan of pink. She likes blue better, so hers are all blue. This one is last year's colourway. This is Robin. But they're great, aren't they? on all of these I've used the vanilla latte pattern on Ravelry. It's a free download, and that's the pattern I stuck to when I was knitting all of these. When you buy the West Yorkshire Spinners Christmas yarn, they give you a free pattern with a ball of yarn as well, and the patterns are really, really good, and they give you lots of instructions, and it tells you the different colourways to use if you want to have contrasting heel toes and cuffs. But you don't have to do that, you can just stick to one colour. And the last year's one was lovely. That was the Fairy Lights one. That one's got red, whereas mine's just got the pink and the blue. But you can also put green in as well. It's nice with the green. There's lots of contrasting colours. There's five different colours you could use in that, because you could have the blue, the pink, the red, the green, or the off-white. They'd all work really well. And last year's one, it was like a wee Christmas card you got. And it opens up in the patterns inside, so that was lovely. And it came in a wee red envelope as well. And the other thing you can do, these ones here, that's the same shade of red that's on the Robin ones and the Candy Cane ones. So the shades of red work with more than one colourway. And this is this year's colourway. It's a nice sparkly blue yarn, and it's called Silent Night. And I've bought some of the Juniper colourway. I'm going to use that for the contrasting heel toes and cuffs. I'm hoping to get a couple of pairs in this colour we knitted up. I was going to knit some for my husband, but I don't know if he'll like the sparkles. Everybody needs a wee bit of bling in their life, don't they? I thought I'd show you these because if you're looking for some yarns and Christmas colourways, these are really nice. And they're not going to break the bank either. I've been having a wee bit of a clear out recently, and I found a few things that I need to finish off. I finished knitting them, but I've not finished weaving in the ends or whatever. So the first thing I'm going to show you is this jumper. I've knitted the whole jumper and I've not worn it because I still need to sew in the ends. So here it is. Can you see that? Okay. I need to block it. I just need to block this and sew in the ends. Isn't she lovely? This is the Sashiko pattern by Bristol Ivy, and it was really nice to knit it. I used Rowan felted tweed. It's a double knitting weight yarn, and I enjoyed knitting with the yarn. Oh, I've got a wee bolly up here, up my sleeve. Get my leftovers still up there, tucked up the sleeve. But I really need to get this blocked so I can wear it, especially in this weather. It's getting colder now. But this was really interesting. It's all knitted in one piece. You actually knit these panels here at the front, and you knit that the panels at the front and the back are knitted first, and then you pick up all your stitches and you start to work out. You leave stitches off at the side for your sleeves. Just pulling a wee bit on this hanger, and then you carry on down the body, and you're increasing stitches at the side. But it's lovely. See, when you see pictures of it being worn, it's really, really pretty. So I need to get this blocked. I need to get those ends sewn in, and then I'll maybe wear this for my next episode. The final thing I'm going to show you in the knitting section is my log cabin cushion. And I've also got a log cabin blanket too. These are knitting patterns that are available on Ravelry. Log cabins seem to be really, really popular just now, and I'm just going to show you my version of it. So that's my cushion, and I'll show you my blanket. That's a wee bit bigger. Maybe I'll have to get up to show you this. There we go. And there's my blanket. Back in. So when I was designing this log cabin pattern, I based it very closely on the patchwork version of a log cabin. Now there's a wee story that goes along with log cabins. I'm just going to get one of my swatches to show you. Maybe find it in here. I've got all my wee swatch bundles from knitting blankets and stuff. There's one there. That's one there. So this is your traditional log cabin, just like the patchwork version. Now, these were actually, the design of these is meant to represent the home. This light side, there's always a lighter side and there's a darker side. And the lighter side represents inside the home. This is the warmer side, it's nice and warm. And this darker side is outside, that's the cold part. And then this wee bit in the middle, the wee red bit, that's the heart of the home. Most of you probably know that if you're patchworking quilters, but if you're not a patchworking quilter, you wouldn't know this. But that's what it's based on. These were used a lot in the Underground Railroad quilts. And you could put different colour squares in the middle. There are quite a few books out there if this is something that you're more interested in, if you would like to learn more about symbolism in quilts. I've only got one book. It's this one here. And it does give you the instructions on how to make your own railroad sampler. But it also gives you a lot of the history of the blocks and the meanings behind even just different colourways that you used in your blocks. It's a really good book. Maybe if you could find it in the library or just if you want to read through it. But this is a good book. I bought mine in Manders in Glasgow. And it was one of those books you're reading on the way home. You're looking through it the way home in the train and you're just thinking, wow. Didn't know that. It's not just a quilting. It's not just a quilting pattern. My log cabin one is already on Ravelry and on Love Knitting, and I've got wee red love heart buttons at the back, just because red symbolises the heart of the home, warmth. And I've also got, this one. This is a Courthouse Steps version. Again, pink and grey, and I've got the little pink buttons on the back for that. So if the two cushions are out, the buttons, the backs were slightly matching. You could sit them that way, or you could sit them that way. I'm not very good at showing things, am I? There we go. But this one's one that I do need to get published. I've not published this one yet. Another knitting pattern that's lying about, waiting to be published. I've got a rail fence one too. I've got the cushion and the quilt made for that. Made that about 4 years ago. And I'm going to show you the blanket version too, okay? Stand up again. Do you like my pink chair? It's a different chair that I'm showing you today. There we go. It's going to come back in. This one's slightly bigger than my log cabin blanket. And you know what, I've never used this one because I've still not published the pattern. So maybe I should get that pattern published and then I can use this blanket over the colder months, can't I? And now we're ready to move on to patchwork and quilting. I haven't been sewing a lot over the past 2 weeks. Just spent more time doing other stuff actually than crafting. Boring stuff that I don't enjoy doing, but it's got to be done. Yesterday I published my Christmas tree pattern on my blog. I'll put a link below where you can find my blog. There she is. Doing it again, calling everything she. And that's just the back. And there's a wee overlap here at the back where your cushion fits in. And I've just bound mine in some green fabric. So that was published yesterday on my blog. You can also download a printed version of a PDF or a printed version, so you can print off a pattern if you would prefer. That's just a pound, that's on Payhip. I know some people prefer to work from a printed version, don't they, rather than doing it online. But that's a Christmas tree there. And before I published it, I did make a second one. So that's the finished one there. See that fabric there? I love that fabric. I'm just going to quickly tell you this before I put it down. When I started designing this, it was initially supposed to be all 2.5-inch squares. But I didn't have enough of this fabric. This is leftovers from making two quilts. They were the Eleanor Burns ones, the Quilt in a Day. But it was there was a log cabin Christmas tree and a log cabin wreath, and I made both of them, and this was a wee bit left over from making both of those. I just love it. I think it's called Here Comes Santa Claus. I just love it. So this was supposed to be 2.5 inch squares, but I didn't have enough of this fabric. So that's why at the side you get strips rather than it. It's less sewn, isn't it? It makes more sense to put it in your strips. I should have maybe cut strips along there as well. When you're putting the green branches of the tree together. But I just love that fabric. And I didn't have enough for the back, so I've just put a beige Christmas tree one in the back. Oh, it's bulging out. It's like me after Christmas. Anyway, I did make another one. I just wanted to make sure that my instructions were okay. So this was the next one that I made. Slightly different fabrics, but I kept the colourways the same because I was doing a photo tutorial. Maybe I should have changed my colours. Because it would have been nice, you could even have a dark background with a white tree. That would be quite nice as well, wouldn't it? And you can see this at the back. I've pressed all my seams open. And you can see here, these seams don't match when you come down here. The sections between the tree, but explain in the tutorial how to join those. Because usually you would match up seams like here. You match up your seams, but you don't match seams when you get to this bit. You're matching with the centre of the block, either above or below, depending on how you sew it together. I'm now thinking I could do one of these in with a dark background, a dark grey background and a pale grey tree. That would go nice in my living room actually. But I'll need to get this one finished. Can't have a panel just lying about, can I? But there you go. This finishes up as an 18 inch cushion pad you fit inside. But I would wait till you're finished before you buy your cushion pad. Just make sure you know what size you need. But it's quite nice. Quite pleased with that. That pattern is on my blog just now. You can go follow the photo tutorial on the blog and make your own one. I also had the snowman. Did I bring that? Yep. And if anybody's interested, if anyone's interested, I can publish this. I might just publish this one later on in November. But see if you're planning on putting them together to make a table runner. Don't trim down your Christmas tree block because this one's a wee bit bigger. It's just slightly bigger, but you could add a wee border around that to make it match. And see this glittery fabric that I've got on mine? If you go onto eBay, you can look for glitter fabric. It's for hair bows and for other crafts. It's a thicker fabric that's covered in glitter and you just cut out the shape you need and you sew it on. You can sew through that on the sewing machine even though it's slightly thicker. But I'm going to publish this one in a couple of weeks. So when will that be? The 19th of November. There's a reindeer one too, but you can let me know if you want this one and I'll prepare the pattern for download. I haven't really worked on anything else, to be honest. That's just about all that I've done in the past 2 weeks. Knitting on the socks and making that Christmas tree block. And that's it. Haven't got a lot done. No crochet at all. But one thing I have done, I bought some fabric. Couldn't resist this when I saw it. And if you don't like cats, look away, because there are people out there that don't like cats. Look at that. And there's more on the other side as well. This is the panels. And there's another two in there as well. And you see the bottom and the tops of them. So cute, isn't it? And they have other matching fabrics. This one's got Christmas tree lights on it. And then this one's just a smaller print of the cats. But there's more as well. There's the snowflakes too. It's lovely. Really nice. The plan was to make a wee bra bag with it, but I think the panels are too big for the pockets in the front of the wee bra bag. So I might just have to make something else. I should have known what size the panels were. I've seen this fabric in Man, not this Christmas one, I've seen the regular Catitude fabric because I've used that for backing quilts just because I love cats. But I've seen it before, I know roughly what size the panels are, so I should have known it would be the same size. I don't know if Manders have got this in, not been there for a couple of months just because I don't go out and about much with the current situation. But you can maybe have a wee look there. And the only other thing that I bought was this kit. This is going to rustle a wee bit. This just arrived this morning and I'm really looking forward to starting this. The Dinosaur Quilt by Elizabeth Hartman. Now I've signed up for a Block of the Month club. It's coming from Olive and Flo Handcraft. I've bought a few things from her, a few kits, a few Block of the Month kits, I should say, and always really enjoy making them. Not that I've finished anything, but you get, this is quite messy. I've not properly opened this yet. But that's all the backing fabric in there for the quilt, and you'll just get a wee bit each month. There's other wee bits and bobs in there. So I've not even opened that properly and looked through it. Lots of rustling. I'm rustling a lot today, aren't I? Just put that down. But I'm really looking forward to starting on this. I love dinosaurs. But that'll be good doing that. And the other thing I would like to start working on is this one. This is an old whip that I've got lying around. This is this quilt, the Gravity Quilt, BJ Bird Quilts. I'll link all these below so you can have a better look at them. But I started this, must be 2013 I started it, because it was before we moved to this house, 2013, 2014 maybe. It's been lying about for a long time and it needs finished. It's a double bed size quilt, a king size. It'll fit my bed anyway, queen size, it's queen size. 97 by 96 inches. And you know, I didn't think I had that much yet done, but I looked it out earlier on today because it's been on my mind a lot. I want to get this finished. And I looked it out and I've actually got 2/3 of it done. So it's all these bits here. So you've got all the different colours and you make all these diamonds. Again, this was a Block of the Month. I got this one from America, but... And because it was only a couple of wee packets of fabric... Sorry, one wee packet of fabric, I think it was, each month. No, it wasn't. It was 2 wee packs of fabric each month to make 2 blocks. It wasn't that expensive, so you didn't get charged customs for it, which was great. Because when you buy things for abroad and then you get charged customs, that's the killer, isn't it? But I do have 12 different diamonds here. And they're all pieced together with different shapes, whether it's hexagons or other wee triangles, diamonds in the middle. I'll no bother showing you them all, okay? But there's 12 of them there. And I've also made miniature versions of them. So all those 12 big blocks, I've got half size versions. So they're all in there too. These were actually to make matching pillows. When I make quilts for my bed, I like a matching pillow. So I thought, you can make this here again, but then half of it can go on one pillow and the other half can go on the other pillow. But that'll be quite nice if I ever get it finished. So I would really like to get working on this as well, because it's just lying about in a cupboard and it's such a waste, isn't it? So much money to be spending and stuff and then not finishing it. So I would like to get that done. So hopefully maybe I'll show you next time. I've got another wee diamond or two. But this was the wee kits that came, which is a couple of wee bags of fabric a month. And you've got all your, that's kind of reds into orange and that one's greens. So when they came through from the States, it was under the customs limit, so no charges, which was great, as I said. And as well as doing, I've made a big block, the regular size block and a half size block. And I've also been cutting out lots of little triangles from each of the colours. Because there's another wee pattern in the book for a cushion that matches too. And I thought I would do that. I'll see if I can show you that without showing off the pattern. There, it's there. So if I just put my hand down there, can you see that wee cushion? I would like to make that too. And I've been cutting out those bits as I'm working each colour. I really like those patterns by J Bird Quilts. She's a lovely quilt designer. And I love following her on Instagram. She's got a lovely wee boy. And I just love her posts. They always make you cheerful, don't they? I like accounts like that. The other quilt that I would like to start working on is my Christmas quilt. I told you about this last time, didn't I? Said I would share more with you. This is how I store all my fabrics. They all get put into these little boxes. I bought these in Tesco's. And that's how I store all my fabric. You normally see that. I've moved my room about a wee bit and I've had a haircut as well. But I store everything in these boxes. Keeps any creepy crawlies or anything out, doesn't it? Stops them getting in and getting in playing with your fabric before you get a chance to play with it. But this is what I want to make. This is a Thimble Blossoms pattern. And again, she's another quilt designer that I really, really like. This is Vintage Holiday 2. I think there was a Vintage Holiday 1. Well, just Vintage Holiday it would have been called at the time. But it's all wee Christmas baubles. And it was a toss-up. I was maybe going to do that one, the Winterville one. But I'll maybe do that with something else. Can you see that? Okay. The light sun is shining on it. But she's got lots of lovely patterns. She's also got a Somerville. I think she's got a ville for every season. There's a Springville and an Autumnville as well. I would like to do the autumn one, but see with blacks and oranges and greens, just kind of Halloween-y colours, I think that would be lovely. And it's something different in the middle, each of these ones. It's a star in the summer one, and it's a snowflake in the winter one. But all the wee houses round about. Really cute, isn't it? So this is the fabric that I'm going to use. Ta-da! This is one of my most favourite Christmas fabric ranges, and it's called Cherry Christmas. It's by Anila Hoey, and I've been stockpiling this for quite some time. I wanted to make this quilt 2 years ago, but I didn't have enough fabric to make what I wanted. So I asked on Instagram, and I didn't find anything on Instagram. But then, lo and behold, I looked on eBay and somebody was selling a bundle. So I managed to get the bundle on eBay and added it to the bundle that I already had. So I've got enough there. I'll give you a wee look at it. There's wee birdies, and I'll just show you different colours. I'll flick through it, and there's some stockings. Will we find a grey? Oh, there's a blue one. Just making sure it's not upside down. Your washing hanging on the line. What else have we got? Ooh, there's some bubbles, bracelets, and what else do we have? Oh, holly. Oh, there's presents. I'll show you that in the... There's little parcels, little presents. I think back in the day when this fabric came out, Anila actually made one of these patterns. Not the Vintage Holiday 2. I think it was just Vintage Holiday she made with this fabric. So, I'm copying her. Because she's awesome. I do have a wee charm pack. With the Cherry Christmas fabrics. You'll not get that now. That'll be hard to find, won't it? So I'm going to enjoy cutting into these because I've been stashing these for some time. But, oh, my wee box is looking a wee bit more empty now that I've pulled some out. But hopefully I can show you a wee bit more of that in a fortnight. That would be good to get that started. I'm just going to try tuck these fabrics away while I finish talking. And I think that's all that I've got to share with you today. As I say, I've not been doing much. Mostly chained to a laptop or a computer. Not been much fun. But these things need doing, don't they? I think that's all I've got to share with you today. So I hope wherever you are in the world, you're keeping safe. I don't know what's going to be happening here shortly. I think we'll begin back into lockdown soon. England's already in lockdown, but we're not in lockdown in Scotland yet. I think the First Minister's going to make an announcement next Tuesday. We'll find out what's going to happen to us. But plenty of quilting and sewing and knitting and crochet to keep me busy, so I think I'll be okay, and I hope you guys will all be okay too. You're all safe and well wherever you are in the world. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'll see you in 2 weeks. Bye.